Okay, now see, I'm giving you certain example how to balance it. This is, so first of all, I'll take the example, the reaction between hydrogen and oxygen. So first of all, I will write the molecular formula H2 plus O2, and it gives you the H2O. Now you can see here, on the left hand side, hydrogen have two atoms, oxygen have two atoms. This side oxygen have only one atom in the molecule of water. So in the molecule of water it has got only, and H2O has got the maximum number of atoms. Maximum kind of atom, there are two type of atom. Maximum number of atom, it has got three atoms. That is why we should balance it very first according to the rule. So now on the left hand side there are two oxygen. On the right hand side only one oxygen is there. To balance it, we multiply it by two. So now the number of oxygen atom become two. But in doing this, this hydrogen become 2 to 4. Four hydrogen atom now. So on the left hand side we should balance it. There should be four hydrogen atoms, and that is why we should multiply it by two. So now this become four hydrogen. Become four hydrogen. This is the four oxygen, two oxygen atoms, and this side four hydrogen atom, two oxygen atom. So this equation become balanced. Now we'll take the another example, reaction between the carbon monoxide and oxygen, and it will give us carbon dioxide. Now you can see number of oxygen this side 3, number of carbon only 1, but the number of oxygen on left hand side, 2 oxygen atom here and 1 oxygen atom here, it has got 3 oxygen, but this side on the product side it has got only 2. So now we have to balance it. How to balance? I have to make that same number. So now if we put 2 behind the carbon monoxide, then it become 2 carbon and 2 oxygen. So now it become 2 oxygen, and here 2 oxygen. So 2 oxygen and 2 oxygen become 4 oxygen, and that is why on the right hand side there must be 4 oxygen. So that is why CO2 should be multiplied with the 2, and in this way now the carbon, oxygen become 4. Now we'll carry out the balancing of carbon. Now the right hand side you can see there are 2 carbon, on left hand side there are 2 carbon. So now carbon is automatically balanced. As so in this way we have got the balanced chemical equation. Now I'll take the another example, like the reaction between ammonia and hydrochloric acid, and it gives us ammonium chloride. Now you can see this ammonium chloride has got the maximum number of atoms, and maximum kind of atoms also is with ammonium chloride only. So that is why we have to balance it accordingly. So this side it has got 4 hydrogen, this side also you have 3 hydrogen, and 3 hydrogen in ammonia and 1 hydrogen in HCl. So 4 hydrogen is there, it is balanced. Now I will check the another chlorine. So this side on the left hand side there are only 1 chlorine atom, on right hand side there are only 1 chlorine atom. So again it is also balanced. Now in ammonia you can see only 1 nitrogen is there, on right hand side only 1 nitrogen is there. So this equation is automatically balanced, no need to balance it. It is a balanced chemical equation. Okay. Now I will take the example of dissociation of mercuric oxide HGO. Okay, you heat it, it will dissociate into mercury and oxygen. Now you can see in this example, this side only one mercury and this side only one mercury atom. So both side mercury is balanced, but on right hand side there is two oxygen atom, on left hand side only one oxygen atom. So it, we should make it same number of atoms. So if you put two here, it now it becomes two oxygen atoms. So now the oxygen atom got balanced, but in doing so mercury become unbalanced. So again we have to balance the mercury. Now this side it has got two mercury atoms, so this side there should be two mercury. That is why we multiply it by two. Now this equation become balanced because both the side each kind of atoms are equal, both the sides. Now we can take the example of dissociation of copper nitrate. So when you heat, it will get dissociated into copper oxide, nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. So this is the decomposition reaction of copper nitrate. Now you can see on the left hand side there are 6 oxygen, 3 2 is 6, 6 oxygen. So this side also there must be 6 oxygen. So 2 oxygen with nitrogen dioxide and 2 oxygen atoms are here, so 4. So there must be 6. So if we put here 2, then now it becomes 6 oxygen. So now the number of oxygen is balanced. But in doing so, number of copper atom become more. Now copper become unbalanced. This side only one copper and this side two copper. So that is why to balance the copper atom, now we should multiply copper nitrate with the 2. Now the copper becomes balanced. But in doing so, we have got 2 nitrogen and then you multiply it by 2. So there are 4 nitrogen. Now nitrogen become unbalanced. Now on the left hand side there are 4 nitrogen. 2, 2 is 4, 4 nitrogen. So that is why we should multiply the nitrogen dioxide with the 4 to balance the nitrogen atom. Now the nitrogen become balanced. Now we have to look at the oxygen, whether it got balanced or not, because earlier it was balanced but now it might become unbalanced. So here now you can see 3 2 is 6, 6 2 is 12, there must be 12 oxygen. 2 oxygen here, 4 2 is 8 oxygen, so 8 to 10 plus 2 12. So now the even oxygen become balanced. In this way this chemical reaction become balanced. So these are the examples of balancing the equation. We'll take one more example here. Like water, when electricity is passed through it, it dissociates into hydrogen. Now you can see hydrogen is balanced but oxygen is not balanced. This side there are only one oxygen atom, this side there are two oxygen atom. So that is why we should multiply this with the 2 so that oxygen become 2. Now this oxygen become 2 and this oxygen 2. Now this side there are 4 hydrogen. So to balance the 4 hydrogen we should multiply this hydrogen with the 2 so that both the side should it should become 4 hydrogen. Now the hydrogen and oxygen both got balanced either side. same number of hydrogen and oxygen is there, thus this question is balanced. So I think now you have understood how to balance the chemical equations. So these are the example how to balance. You should practice more to balance the chemical equation with the help of book. You practice it with the NCERT book as well as with the S. Chand. So I am recommending the S. Chand books. Thank you. So now you concentrate on balancing the equation, and I'll meet you with another video.